Standing in the heart of Converse Basin today, it is difficult to imagine how different it looked less than 100 years ago. The Converse Basin Mill was one of several lumber operations in the Southern Sierra Nevada that cut giant sequoia, along with most of the trees that grew among them. In the late 1800s, the demand for timber was voracious, and the lumber companies strained to meet this need. Ironically, the brittle wood of the 2,000-year-old giants often shattered into pieces to be used merely for shingles or grape stakes. What started as a small protest by a few individuals soon became a national outcry to save the redwoods. In response, most of the remaining privately owned giant sequoia groves were purchased and placed under the protection of the federal government on lands managed by the Forest Service and Park Service.
There are 75 naturally occurring groves within the United States. Of those 75 groves, 41 are found on national forest lands.
Preserving these monarchs has turned out to be a complicated task. People wanted these treasures protected, not only from the axe, but from fire. As firefighting tools and technology improved, so did the ability to fight wildfires. The sequoia trees, however, began to lose the battle. New reproduction was not occurring. Fires, which are a natural part of the Sierra ecosystem, create bare soil and large openings for sunlight. These are essential elements for the survival of young sequoia. As part of an effort to replicate the effects of fire and stimulate new growth, the Forest Service began to cut the competing trees in the giant sequoia groves.
We began to actively manage giant sequoia groves to ensure that giant sequoia seedlings would have the competitive edge in the groves. In doing that, we did not recognize what the public reaction was. There was a tremendous public outcry. As a result of that outcry, we halted all management actions within giant sequoia groves.
The range of the giant sequoia is limited to a small band within the Sierra Nevada of California. A major portion of giant sequoia groves are located on national forest lands. Some groves are designated in areas such as wilderness, research natural areas, botanical, and historical areas. Management emphasis is on grove protection. Meanwhile, a major effort is underway to better understand this evolving plant species and restore giant sequoia for the future.
The Forest Service's policy, now and in the future, is to preserve, to protect, and to restore giant sequoia groves. Specifically, we are mapping the groves, we are accelerating our research efforts, and we are establishing a partnership effort with a broad array of public groups and individuals. We're doing this to ensure that there will be generations of Americans who can enjoy generations of giant sequoias.